From this, to this, to this, to this, to this final look. How's it guys, everyone? I'm Neat, and today we're gonna see how important contrast is when it comes to color grading in Final Cut Pro. It's gonna be a step-by-step tutorial, a very beginner-friendly video, so let's get it. Talking about contrast, contrast can mean a lot of things, especially when you try to create something, video or picture. But today, we want to talk about two specific types of contrast, and they definitely need to be a part of your color grading process. First, we're going to talk about tonal contrast, which means the difference of brightness in an image or in a footage between your brightest tones and the dark tones in your footage. And then we're going to talk about color contrast, which is the harmony between different hues, brightness, and saturation of different colors in your footage. So let's look at the tonal contrast first in this first example right here. The footage is very flat, so let's look at the Luma vector scope. So before we add tonal contrast, let's make sure that our footage is properly exposed. I use the color wheels for this process, so let's increase the brightness of the highlights until it reaches close to 100 and lower the shadows until it gets close to 0. This way we'll retain as much information in both the highlights and the shadows. So let's add contrast. And I like to use the curves adjustment for contrast. On the curves adjustments, if you're not familiar with it, the left side will be your shadows, and as you go up to the right, that will be your highlights. So because we want to create brightness contrast or tonal contrast, I'm going to make the shadows darker and the highlights brighter. So click here and that will create a point and drag it down. And the same up here, drag it up. I'm going to drag it up. So check this out. Look at the difference. You can see the difference, right? Now, this footage right here needs more saturation. So we're gonna add another color wheels and just drag the left side of the global wheel to add saturation. All right, I like it. Now when you do this, it actually looks like the dark area went further away from the screen and the bright areas came closer. That's tonal contrast. It gives you that illusion. And guys, this is just one way to create depth in your footage. Now let's go even further with this clip. Let's add a look, a grade. Yeah, we're definitely color grading today. The plan is to isolate the skin tone and then create the popular teal and orange look. Let's take another color wheels to do this, and this time create a color mask. Click here and add color. Now we can use the eyedropper tool to select the skin tone and then play with the HSL sliders to refine your selection. Actually, I highly recommend to click on View Mask to see your selection. Yeah, you gotta see what you're selecting, right? And before you panic, what you see as white is your selection. So refine it until you're satisfied, and then you're done. Click on View Mask again, and let's click on Outside. That means that all adjustments that we're gonna do right now will be applied to the dark area of this selection. Okay, so let's drag this down to gradually add teal in the non-selected area. See what that does to our footage? Look at that. Before and after. You know, teal and orange creates this color contrast, and that's because teal and orange are complementary colors on the color wheel. Okay, we gotta talk more about color contrast. Let's look at this second example. I already went through the process of adding tonal contrast in this footage. You know, all the contrast, bright and dark and all that stuff. But look at these colors. We can see green, red, orange, and yellow. And it looks like green is a dominant color here, but what we see as green is usually actually a combination of yellow and green. And yellow is a hue that is very close to orange, which is a major part of the skin tone. So we can create a contrast between these colors right here, between the green and the skin tone. And to do that, we want to take the yellow and make it more green so that we can create that contrast. And the best tool to use for this is the hue versus hue curves, and maybe the hue versus saturation curves as well. Hue versus hue is all about colors. So let's use the eyedropper tool and select the yellow leaves, and then we can drag it down until we're satisfied, of course. And look at that, it makes a difference. It was a lot yellowish before, and now with just that simple color adjustment, the girl stands out more because now the yellows are more green. We can also play around with the saturation, like I said before, and the brightness of the plants. So we can desaturate the greens and the yellows by using hue versus sat. Look at that. It might actually create more contrast if you make them more saturated because the girl is already a little bit desaturated. Okay, I think it works better like this. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section if you like the green more saturated in this footage or less saturated. So now let's decrease the luma or the brightness of the same color by using hue versus luma. Okay, let's look at the result. There it is. Color contrast, people. Manipulating hues, saturation and brightness or luma. Quick pro tip. Since we're already here, I always make sure that the darkest area stays black and the brightest part stays white. And so I take the saturation away from both sides of the luma versus sat curve, and that's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe today and go check out these tips on color grading, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.